are coming to you live from a sold-out Tropical Park Stadium right here in Miami, Florida. It's the 2021 Summer Classic Tournament. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I am your host, Jimmy Justice, and I am so excited, if you couldn't tell already, to be here tonight, because tonight and tomorrow night, we will determine the number one contender and the main event for Cyber Slam 7 and the World Heavyweight Championship. But first up tonight, ladies and gentlemen, a match out of Bracket D as Janikowski goes one-on-one with VLK.
This is your opening contest for the 2021 Summer Classic. And it is a Bracket D match scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from parts unknown and weighing in at 300 pounds, he is Janikowski.
Well, here you see him, Janikowski. It's good to see him back and here in Miami, Florida for the Summer Classic Tournament. Wearing quite an unusual getup, the mind games as usual, kind of getting ahead of the opponent, is Janikowski. About to go one-on-one with a guy that can stand toe-to-toe with some of the biggest monsters right here in ROC. You know him and you love him. Here he comes.
And his opponent, from Antwerp, Belgium, weighing in at 275 pounds, he is VLK.
You talk about a guy who's done it all here in Ring of Chaos. VLK, one of the most decorated wrestlers right here in Ring of Chaos. He's looking to get back into the world title picture. It's like he was here a couple of months ago. And what a way to do it would be to go to Cyber Slam 7, go to the main event. But folks, we got a long tournament ahead of us, and this is how we're gonna start it. And this is gonna be a war between two monsters. Oh, out the gates. Janikowski coming hard with the big strikes. Oh. Got the arm. And now, oh, the kicks and then that big lariat, that short arm lariat by Janikowski. You see Janikowski back in the ROC ring. Off that big leg drop, brother. Here's the cover. Could have him here in advance. Oh, two count only. VLK just kicking out. I was going to say Janikowski making his way back from the IGP. These wrestlers, just because you don't see them on ROC TV doesn't mean they're not still competing. But VLK, you're going to see him on ROC TV every single week. One of the best workhorses right here in Ring of Chaos. And here we go, the match spilling to the outside. But Janikowski quickly getting it back in the ring. And that's what it's all about, traditional mat wrestling here in the Summer Classic Tournament. Let me go over the rules with you, ladies and gentlemen. The first round of the tournament. Oh, big knee there. 10-minute single fall matchups, pure matchups. It's not going to be until we get to the semifinals, 15-minute time limit, and then in the finals. The finals is going to be a 15-minute time limit with anarchy rules, ladies and gentlemen. And that'll be tomorrow night's main event. Oh, VLK sending him shoulder first and then driving the knee braces right into the face. This qualification obviously takes you out of the tournament, but count out will as well. Double DQ or a double count out, both men will be eliminated from the tournament. So the winner of their predecessor in their bracket will get a bye, essentially. Big boot by Janikowski. Now, oh, another one. Big boots from Janikowski. Might be looking at that bracket B, because the winner of this bracket, oh God, bracket D faces bracket B. Here's the cover, big boot. Only got a one count. Janikowski, oh, big kick there. Straight to the chest by Janikowski. And he's been all over VLK in this matchup so far. Just wrenching at the neck, the torque on the neck. Trying to wear VLK down in every way possible right now. And Janikowski and Camel Clutch ripping at the face. Good God. Oh. VLK now powering out of it though. Oh, and a reverse DDT by VLK trying to get back in this matchup here in the Summer Classic Tournament. VLK to the top rope. Janikowski getting to his feet. Oh! Big shoulder block off the top rope. Might have been a headbutt. I couldn't really tell from that angle. VLK taking Janikowski over to the rope. And now, oh, off the middle rope with the European uppercut. That could be it. VLK could be advancing, but Janikowski kicking out at one. I thought he could be advancing in the D bracket here. Janikowski able to kick out at one. Straight kick to the face there. Nothing technical about this matchup. Just a straight fight here so far. Big forearm to the face now. Janikowski trying to regain control of this matchup. Back and forth we go. Chops and strikes, kicks. Just a brawl here in the opening matchup of the 2021 Summer Classic. Strikes, punches and chops and punches. And now, oh, Janikowski off the chop counter. Big powerbomb into an elbow drop right in the middle of the ring. And Janikowski to going for here. Oh, look at the torque on that Samoan drop. Here's the cover. Lateral press, only getting a two count off that lateral. And now Janikowski in the center rope here. Knowing his size, not trying to go up too high, take too much of a risk. Double axe handle, straight to the top of the dome. VLK going for the cover, not advancing in the 2021 Summer Classic. Janikowski has been in control most of this matchup, but now VLK trying to fight back here. Janikowski getting out of the way. Now working the arm here. VLK fighting back though. punches to the gut. Now the kicks. Oh, and the straight knee to the face. Janikowski is dazed. And he's got him up on the shoulder, dropping him down on the knees, trying to take the big man down by his knees. A technical prowess coming through from VLK, now going for the cover. Only getting a one count. Janikowski is going to be a hard man to beat. And this match is over halfway over. Irish whip into the corner here. Sent hard. Now the Belgian suplex from the man from Belgium. Antwerp to be exact in the big elbow drop. The twerk on that elbow drop. Twerk for days in this match. And slamming the head into the mat is VLK. VLK looking to advance in the 2021 Summer Classic. Getting absolutely vicious here in the deep part of this matchup. Big superplex, mini superplex, if you will. Countering, and then he's got him, goes under the choke slam. Janikowski could be looking to advance in the 2021 Summer Classic Tournament. Oh, but VLK just kicks out at two. Janikowski to the middle rope, body splash straight to the small in the back, and now he's feeling it here. Off the rope, going for another big boot. VLK countering off the ropes himself on a spear. He got him with the big spear as a cover. Look at the leg. It's over.
And your winner of the match, VLK.
There you see VLK getting it done with the spear. And then the 1, 2, 3, just getting out of this matchup here tonight. VLK, that spear looking stronger than ever. The best in the business, ladies and gentlemen. And he's advancing. He's gonna face the winner of Angelo Morocco and Anders coming up in our co-main event here tonight. See the bracket. Let's get it updated, folks. VLK moving on. We're going to be moving on in this tournament. Ladies and gentlemen, so glad you are here tonight, because coming up next, Xander, Bruce Bryant, Bracket B, you better be bested.
Is a Bracket B match scheduled for 1-5. Introducing first, from Tokyo, Japan, weighing in at 219 pounds, Bruce Bryant.
Bruce Bryant here in Miami tonight, looking to get the best of Xander and advance in Bracket B. He looks ready.
His opponent from Toronto, Ontario, Canada, weighing in at 315 pounds, he is Xander.
Well, the X Express is here, ladies and gentlemen, and he's ready for this Bracket B matchup. Xander's setting on Saturday night in Main Event 7, letting Kane know you want to see him make it to the finals of the Summer Classic Tournament. Xander looking confident and looking ready here tonight. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Rookie versus veteran. ROC rookie, that is. We know Bruce Bryant, even though he's a rookie here in ROC, he's been wrestling for a very long time. I'd be remiss if I didn't mention that. Now, Bruce Bryant starting this matchup off. Kind of trying to get away from Xander's offense here. Going for the cover off that big elbow drop. We're getting our one count. Be interesting to see if Bruce Bryant, can best Xander here tonight. Move on in bracket B. Right now, Xander laying in those fists to the brain of Bruce Bryant. Now, that choke toss. Xander going straight to his bag of tricks tonight, not wasting any time. It seems like he's ready for this tournament, but so is Bruce Bryant now countering. Nice kick there. Springboard just got a piece of him. That springboard senton. And a big knee straight to the back. Bruce Bryant trying to get the big man up, but Xander said, I don't think so. And now Xander, pump handle drop. Into a punch straight to the face. Trying to break the face of Bruce Bryant. Big splash, getting 10 feet in the air. Going for the cover, could be advancing in a 2021 Summer Classic, but Bruce Bryant is able to kick out at 2. Xander, big German suplex. A short arm clothesline there. Nice transition there from Xander. Now Bruce Bryant countering the Irish whip, but Xander powering him down. Obviously the bigger man of the two. Going to use that size advantage and try to move on here tonight. Bruce Bryant, though, coming quick with the strike, though. Now up to the top rope. Big frog splash. Going for the cover. Hook of the leg. Only getting a one count. The winner of this matchup will go on to face the winner of D2000 or Nucci. Bruce Bryant, though, looking impressive so far. Could be advancing here. I believe that's his finisher that he calls Scarlet No Tsubasa. But Xander just able to kick out at 1. I don't think that was even a one count. Bruce Bryant now. The strikes, Xander countering and striking back here. Looking to take advantage of the counter situation here. Now Xander, he's back in control here of this matchup now. But Bruce Bryant continuing to fight back. And sending the head of Xander right off the turnbuckle post. Xander counting back and forth we go. Now Xander Gonna bounce his head off the turnbuckle post more than one time. The crowd is counting along. Oh, only getting this six. Bruce Bryan countering his seven. Oh, and a big bulldog there. Now Bruce Bryan bouncing off the ropes and delivering a picture-perfect elbow straight to the chest of Xander. Here's the cover. Hook of the leg, only getting a one count. Got a big uphill battle here against Xander. Does Bruce Bryan in bracket B. Now Bruce sending Xander to the outside. Now measuring him up here. Off the ropes. Oh! And that suicide plancha over the top rope. A pressure moment here for Bruce Bryant. And so far he is capitalizing. You know what they say about pressure. Oh! It creates diamonds. And he just dropped his head on the concrete. Nothing but concrete under that padding. Not quite as hard as the diamond, but it's hard enough. Xander trying to fight back after being sent into the steps. And sending Bruce Bryan into the barricade here. Bracket B, Bruce Bryant barricade. Oh, pump handle into a punch once again. Xander getting it back in the ring. Breaking up the count at eight. Xander wants to do this the right way, but that's not how he's gonna do it though, not with the steps. I think he just saw those steps and a little instinct took over. All the battles he's had with Kane lately. Oh God, X-Nuke incoming! Oh God, right on the steps! Bruce Bryant has been, what's the word about death that starts with a B? I don't know, he's dead. He's dead, damn it. He just got X-nuked. He's been bombed. Oh. Now face first. Bruce Bryant. What? Back to his feet. Bruce Bryant. Oh my gosh. How is he doing? Where is he getting this from? Oh, but Xander. Xander's done with all that. X-nuke incoming. Oh, wait a minute. Bruce Bryant countering. Where's he getting his from? Were they feeding him in Tokyo, Japan? And strikes. And strong style strikes by Bruce Bryant. Trying to advance in bracket B. And once again sending Xander to the outside. Gonna go for another suicide plancha. Right out here in front of me. Oh! We hear the crowd here in Tropical Park Stadium here in Miami, Florida, loving every moment of Bruce Bryant's brilliance here in bracket B. Now bounced off the top of our announce table is Bruce Bryant and sent back into the ring. Xander utilizing his environment to his advantage. That's what he does best. And now Xander knees straight to the to the neck, and then a reverse DDT. Now Xander regaining control of this matchup after a spurt of offense from Bruce Bryant. Back on the outside again. Xander looking for an X-bomb, perhaps. Oh, and he hit it on the apron, the hardest part of the ring. That's almost as bad as an X-nuke. Xander, all he gotta do is toss him in the ring, cover him, and he's gonna advance in the Summer Classic. Oh, wait a minute. He's not done. He wants another X-bomb. Oh, big punches to the gut here. Oh, but Bruce Bryant countering. Oh, a couple of knees sending Xander down to the ground, to the mat. Now Strong style strikes coming out once again, but Xander, he's only got one strike. And that was with his head, a big headbutt there. Now, Xander looking for the X-Bomb. He's got him up, and there it is. Xander looking the best Bruce Bryant in advance in bracket B. He's got it.
And your winner, Xander.
Well, it's too bad for Bruce Bryant in bracket B, but Xander advancing here in the 2021 Summer Classic Tournament, ladies and gentlemen. Not taking anything away from Bruce Bryant. What an incredible matchup we just witnessed between these two guys. Now we're gonna go ahead and update this bracket and see Xander moving on to face the winner of D2000 and Nucci, ladies and gentlemen. Coming up next, a match out of bracket A, Gordon Gaines and Reed Nevermore Andrew. Still got a ton more to come tonight, folks.
The following is a bracket A match scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from the House of Gaines, weighing in at 275 pounds, he is Gordon Gaines.
Nah, get it right, not Jay Balboa. It's the glorious House of Gaines. And ladies and gentlemen, this is my pick right here. This guy right here. Gordon Gaines, the man who has nothing left to lose, to win this whole thing, ladies and gentlemen.
And his opponent, weighing in at 220 pounds, from Bridgeport, Connecticut, he is Reed Nevermore Andrews.
You gotta think the spirit of a Tommy behind Reed Nevermore Andrews. He's got more momentum now than ever, which makes him one dangerous competitor in the 2021 Summer Classic Tournament. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Big matchup here between these two guys. Oh! Gordon Gaines coming out the gates with a big boot straight to the face of Reed Andrews. And as I mentioned, Gordon Gaines coming in this matchup, well, he's got nothing left to lose. As I've said, he's seen a lot of failures this season. But this is his opportunity, and that's why I'm picking him, because desperate men who have nothing left to lose will go at it head first. And that's a way you can get it done. Because he could be focused on this, not have any outside distractions, and that could be what does it for him here tonight. But Reed Nevermore Andrews is going to be one tough customer to defeat. Big power slam there by Gordon Gaines, followed up with a big fist drop straight to the face. Now, nice counter there, Fireman Carey takedown, fired up by a gigantic knee straight to the face of Gordon Gaines. Face first into the mat here in this A bracket matchup. The winner of this matchup goes on. Oh, wait a minute. Springing to the outside, landing right on top of Gordon Gaines is Reed Nevermore Andrews. As I mentioned, winner of these guys in this bracket A matchup go on to face winner of either Dane Xavier or Vega here in tonight's main event. Of course, you can't forget that Dane Xavier is in bracket A. He would not let you forget about it. Oh! Saturday night's main event, but back to this matchup, back to the action. Gordon Gaines just sent Nevermore hard into that steel barricade. Oh, and now into the steel steps. Referee counting here, but counting diligently, realizing that this Summer Classic tournament, he wants to keep it competitive. Doesn't want to see anybody getting a bye here in this Summer Classic tournament. Now Gordon Gaines going up to the top rope. Oh, going for a big frog splash. But Reed Andrews is able to get the knees up, and now, oh! A discus forearm straight to the back of the neck. An elbow straight to the face, back and forth we go. The strikes. Oh, nice neck breaker there by Reed Nevermore Andrews. Nice European uppercut there. Shades of fellow Tommy member Anders. Now onto the apron. Oh! Using the rope as a weapon, utilizing his environment. And using that rope for a neck breaker. Now, oh! Springing into the ring. It was kind of like a modified spear from behind. I remember doing that to somebody at a bar a few years ago. Anyways, both these men getting back to their feet here. And now Gordon Gaines. Oh, big shoulder breaker there by the Gaines man. Oh! A big boot straight to the face. Gordon Gaines coming out of the house of Gaines, bringing all the power here tonight. Not missing leg day. Delivering that big knee straight to the ribs. And now Gordon Gaines. Oh! That winding Samoan drop. Saw Janikowski do that earlier tonight. The torque on that. Now, oh, short arm clothesline there. Gordon Gaines, the Gaines maker. I think he realizes that's not gonna be enough, so he's looking to do more damage to Nevermore with that stiff lariat. And now dumping Reed Andrews to the outside. What the hell?
Gordon Gaines, I see your pain. You thought to be a god, you needed recognition. Real gods require blood.
Well, I don't know who. I guess that Tommy's in the production room messing with shit. What the hell is this all about now? Oh, come on. He's got that cross-faced chicken wing locked in on Gordon Gaines. On Gordon Taps.
And your winner, Nevermore.
Well, there you see it. Reed Nevermore Andrews getting it done with that cross-faced chicken wing. But not before playing some mind games with Gordon Gaines. Good God almighty. What have we witnessed here, ladies and gentlemen? I'm a little taken aback by what we just saw. The video on the Titantron. Talking about blood. That's what Gordon Gaines, that's a callback to an older version, an older personality of Gordon Gaines. I don't know what that's all about. I guess time will tell, but back to the action, folks. Moving on, Reed Nevermore Andrews, bracket A. Congratulations to him, moving on. Folks, coming up next is a matchup out of Bracket C. Humpty making his return, going against Kane.
The following is a Bracket C match, scheduled for 1-4.
Gordon Gaines, my bracket has been busted. I had him winning this whole freaking thing. Now I just lost about $3,000. Oh well. But now this is my new pick. 666 pounds of flames and fire and it just, I'm not even scared of it anymore because I'm so used to this guy coming out here. And he's ready, obviously, for the Summer Classic Tournament. But here comes the Hump Man. Ladies and gentlemen, back in the flesh, the original Hump Man, baby. Come on, y'all. So the way I'm dancing over here. Okay, I gotta digress. Sit back down. Whew, feel like I just had a match. Get back to this. Back to the action here. Starting this big matchup. Got about 1,000 pounds of weight standing in that ring. 2 grand if you can't count Tim Horton's fat ass. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Bracket C, this is the bracket to watch here. Two of the biggest men in ROC. Seems like Humpty is back on that diet. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Back and forth, these two go. Coming out the gates with the strikes. And everybody in this tournament so far has come out, oh, with a head full of steam. Big punch straight to the gut. Everybody Hump C. Bracket C. I guess you could call Kane Hump C. That'd be an interesting tag team. Hump C and Hump T. Here we go. Back to the action. Kick out. Humpty countering the big elbow with a big elbow there, going for a lariat. Unable to take down 666 pounds. Oh, but the second time, he gets more momentum coming off those ropes. You gotta think Humpty, he's gotta be close to 666 pounds. And now, bouncing Kane off the barricade, off the ring post. Ladies and gentlemen, so glad you could be with us here tonight in Miami, Florida for the Summer Classic Tournament. We're seeing a big matchup here. You talk about big men. Oh, I don't think it gets any bigger than these guys. Big punch to the gut once again by Kane. Now a kick straight to the face. Kane, you gotta think he's looking to get to those finals. Xander's already moved on. Oh! In his bracket. Now it's up to Kane to try to move on. But right now, he's in control with that big spear, bringing Humpty to the outside. It seems like no matter what kind of match Kane is in, oh, big knee there. Seems like he's always trying to get hardcore. It's just instinct for him. Going for a cover here, only getting a one count. I think that's rubbed off on Xander. We saw Xander earlier tonight grabbing the steps, trying to get hardcore. These two just have a natural inclination to get hardcore, but right now, Humpty countering and getting in control, using the elbow as his mode of offense right now. And now bugging, yeah! Let's get going again with the dance, baby! Woo! Oh, wait a minute. Oh, you gotta watch out behind you, though. You gotta watch out! Oh! See, that's my problem. I get too busy dancing and I forget to do my job. Here's the cover. Oh, 2 count only. He just kicks out. A big knee by Kane. I'm surprised Humpty was able to kick out. And now, oh God. Suplex powerbomb facebuster into the ropes. Classic Kane now going for a cover. That's gotta be it. He's gonna advance. Oh, but Humpty once again, barely getting his shoulder up at 2. Kane, what's he got planned here? He's got him up on the shoulders. Oh, torture rack. Oh, you don't see much of this move anymore. That's a big man to be doing it to, but Humpty countering out. And now backbreaker into a rush, side rushing leg sweep by Humpty. Ever since Humpty got his groove back, there you see. Back and better than ever. Big forearm straight to the face. And now, oh, that lariat. while Kane was down, delivering a lariat, make him put him even further down into the ground, but not able to make him dead like what Kane wants to do to him here in this matchup. Oh, now Kane, he's got him goozled. Oh, Google what goozled means, because I don't even know what it means. He's got him grasped by the throat and just delivered a straight punch, but now Humpty fighting back. Oh, out of the corner. Elbow straight to the face, sending Kane down to the ground, to the mat. Humpty is feeling himself. He is groovified and humpified. He went back to Nigeria to rebuild his roots, only to come back. I feel like it's 2014 all over again, folks. Cranking on the neck, the torque there. By Humpty, and now speaking of torque, single leg Boston Crab. Not able to put enough torque on that big meaty leg, and Kane able to power out. Now Goozle once again. Oh, that shot to the gut. Bringing Humpty down to his knees. And now Kane, what's he going to do here? Oh! Powerbomb into a cutter. He says that's it, it's done. Going for the cover. Oh, but Humpty once again kicking out at 2.5. Now, raking at the eyes and the face of Humpty is Kane. Bringing the violence. Oh, my God. Modified sidewalk slam there. Going for the cover. Oh! Only able to get a 2 count. Humpty barely getting his shoulder up out of these 2 counts. Now, Irish whip by Humpty after the counter. Need a couple of knees and then a side rushing leg sweep. Humpty measuring the 7 foot, 666 pound Kane up and delivering a big flying cross body. Didn't see that coming from the big man. He could be advancing. Oh, 2 count only. Getting deep in this matchup. Anybody's ball game here so far. Been even all the way through here in this matchup. What a matchup it's been. But Kane back to his feet. Big backbreaker. On another one. He's going to do another one, isn't he? Oh! A trifecta of backbreakers by the monster. The Resident Evil monster, Kane. And now, oh God. Deadlifts him up. Oh, and he transitions him for the dominator. The dominance. The dominance. Oh, another one. The dominance of Kane. Bringing the pain. Here's the cover. He got him.
And your winner, Kane.
Well, the Resident Evil monster Kane bringing the pain here tonight in bracket C. What a performance. What a matchup we just witnessed between two monsters. We'll go ahead and update this bracket. Kane moving on in bracket C to face the winner of Sean Extreme and Frank Walker. And that match is coming up next, ladies and gentlemen, and we will know who the finalists of bracket C will be. They're vying for a shot at the main event of Cyber Slam 7.
the main event. It's the main event. You think I'm not going to be in a main event?
Thank you, man.
I'd rather be in the main event than breathe.
The following is a Bracket C match scheduled for one fall.
Goes out to the business, Sensei. You better hope you're recording. Hey, I said prepare for your doomsday. See me in the sky with Mr. King, clock for the
king of the Hollywood. Introducing first, from Orlando, Florida, weighing in at 230 pounds, he is Sean Extreme.
Well, here he is, Sean Extreme. He's not alone tonight, not with Jasmine. One half of Kings of the World by himself here tonight. Dan Xavier saying, this is a one-on-one environment. I'm not giving you any advantages, Sean Extreme.
His opponent from Los Angeles, California, weighing in at 230 pounds, he is Frank Walker.
Well, if there's ever a time for Frank Walker to go straight to the top, this is the time. He can fight Walker, fight. He can go all the way to the top of this bracket, of this 2021 summer tournament bracket. And he can go on to the main event, Cyber Slam 7, folks. Ready is the theme of the night. All these guys looking ready. And no two wrestlers are more ready than these guys. These are the two of the hungriest guys in Ring of Chaos. Sean Extreme with that big scoop slam. And now, gonna lock it up in the middle of the ring. Frank Walker getting the better of the exchange, backing him into the corner. You see here, a clean break by these guys. This pure, oh, matchup, I said I spoke too soon. Sean Extreme faking him out here. Now taking the time to taunt to the crowd. Meanwhile, Frank Walker gonna take advantage, delivering some quick strikes here. As I said, these are two of the hungriest guys in Ring of Chaos. Frank Walker having never won a title here in Ring of Chaos. Sean Extreme, he's never won a world title. So these guys, they're chomping at the bit because of how hungry they are. We get to the main event of CyberSlam 7. Frank Walker sliding out of the ring and using his agility and delivering a lariat there. Now dragging Sean Extreme to the center of the ring. A nice fireman carry takedown counter there by Sean Extreme. Sean Extreme is one of the best ring shapes of his life. And you gotta give a lot of credit to Dan Xavier for that. Working with him every single day, making him better, and giving him a better wrestling mind. Right now, Frank Walker looking for the Frankensteiner, but Sean counters. Now he's got him backed up in the corner here. Oh, but Frank Walker countering there, using a little bit of power, and then doing that same taunt that Dan Xavier does. Sean Extreme's tag team partner trying to get in his head, but he's met with a float over DDT. Frank Walker, another guy who's learned a lot over the last year or so. Both these guys, a lot of their hunger comes from how much they've learned, how much they've worked to get better. And now Frank Walker going for a powerbomb, but Sean Extreme counters into a Hurricane Rana roll-up. Frank Walker countering, a counter by Sean. The referee keeping up with the pin counts, a tight eye on this action. Now Sean Extreme, Irish whip here, going for that spinning kick. Frank Walker has just a little bit more agility than he does. They're able to duck out of the way. Sending Sean Extreme into the corner here. Now using that foot, getting that foot up, using that athletic ability. You know, Frank Walker, he does a lot of stretching to be able to do that. Sean Extreme fighting back here. Back and forth we go. Frank Walker talking a little smack, front face lock here. Sean Extreme answering smack talk with wrestling. There's anybody that knows about smack talk and wrestling, it's his tag team partner Dan Xavier. But now, like he was gonna go for the standing Spanish fly there, but Frank Walker countering. Frank Walker, a head full of steam. Body splash in the corner of Sean Extreme, and now, oh! Superman punch going straight into a cover. Taking advantage, could be advancing, but Sean Extreme just kicking out and staying alive in the Summer Classic 2021 tournament. Sean Extreme, fireman carry takedown counter. Frank Walker, counter of his own, catching the foot. Aware of the offense and a big lariat. Sending Sean Extreme to the outside. The referee beginning his count. It's Frank Walker on the apron measuring up Sean Extreme. And delivers a huge lariat. It looks like a lariat. A flying lariat off the apron. And Sean somehow able to fight back right after that move. Now Sean to the top rope. Oh! Froggy elbow there. Frog splash elbow, and now Sean Extreme. Head full of steam, big drop kick there. Sean's feeling it right here in this moment. This could be his chance to advance in the 2021 Summer Classic, but nice counter by Frank Walker. A big Superman punch. This time not going for a cover. We're gonna do some more damage to Sean Extreme. Coming off the rope with that pump kick. Now he's calling for it. Frank Walker looking for the go to hell. Got him up on his shoulders, and there it is. Frank Walker, oh wait a minute. I thought that was gonna be it. Thought he was gonna go for the cover there. Oh! Well, suplex lung blower there. Frank Walker looking to advance in the 2021 Summer Classic Tournament. Oh, but Sean Extreme just able to kick out at two. Frank Walker onto the apron, measuring up Sean Extreme, trying to get the crowd behind him. Frank Walker, what's he gonna go for here? I'll head into the top rope. Oh, he took too much time. Oh! The springboard Spanish fly off the top rope by Sean Extreme, looking to take advantage. Got him up, crosses the legs. Extreme drop. That's gotta be it. And he's got him.
And your winner of the match, Sean Extreme.
Well, there you see it. The Extreme drop getting it done for Sean Extreme. One half of the Kings of the World moving on here in the 2021 Summer Classic Tournament. It's such a shame for Frank Walker not able to reach the top here tonight. Not even able to get off the base of the mountain, but taking nothing away from him here in this matchup. What a matchup we just witnessed between those two guys. Now you see, gonna update this bracket. Sean Extreme moving on, and now we have the finals of Bracket C set between Sean Extreme and Kane. But folks, coming up next, another matchup out of Bracket B, D2000 and Nucci. The winner moves on to face Sander.
The following is a Bracket B match, scheduled for one fall.
Cut my life into pieces. This is my last resort. Suffocation, no breathing. Don't give a fuck if I come out bleeding.
Introducing first, from Cameron, New Jersey, weighing in at 200 pounds, he is Nucci.
What an opportunity this is for the rookie upstart, Nucci. It would be amazing to see if he can advance against this man.
And his opponent, from Buffalo, New York, weighing in at 252 pounds, he is D2000.
You gotta wonder what shape D2000's knees have to be in after what Dan Xavier did to him at Saturday Night's Main Event 7. I'm sure he got prepared as much as he could for this matchup. We're here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. He's gonna put his knees to the test. Well, I hope that Nucci studied the tape of D2000's match against Aldrin Colt, because if he did, he could be the second rookie to upset D2000 here this season. Out the gates, big scoop slam there by the Nooch. Nucci immediately looking to do some ground offense, but D2000 isn't the guy you want to get technical with. D2000 gonna get technical himself out the gates. Going after the knee and then snapping the arm on the mat there, but Nucci back to his feet. Oh, that press slam. Now off the ropes. Oh, Nucci, oh my God. Well, I thought Nucci was gonna fly on the outside, but T2000 rolled inside and he delivered a springboard poison rana. That was impressive. Now a big follow-away slam by Nucci. Nucci starting out impressively here in this matchup, going for a cover, only getting a one count. Nucci's doing exactly what he needed to do, starting this matchup hot. D2000, he's gonna be right there with him every step of the way, and there's no avoiding that. D2000 is just one of the best wrestlers here in ROC, and now gator roll here on the ground, that mat wrestling roll, the front face lock, and he transitions it into a cross face. Some early wear down tactics by D2000. Now hammerlock, oh, into a back suplex, dropping him arm first. And now D2000 to the top, looking for the elbow drop, but Nucci able to get out of the way. And another big follow-away slam there by the Nucci. That's the top rope. What's he looking for here? Frog splash. But D2000 was ready for it a little bit too early. Oh, another drop kick straight to the knee. Oh, Nucci rolling out to the apron instinctively, trying to get some space between he and his opponent, but D2000, like I said, gonna stay with Nucci every step of the way, delivering that rope-assisted neck breaker, and then posing for his adoring fans here in Miami, Florida. Drop down by D2000, another drop down. But, oh, Nucci with that big boot there. And now, Dragon Sleeper by Nucci. D2000 quickly able to counter out of it. Now, oh! A suplex there, only getting a one count out of it off the bridge. Now D2000. So far, this matchup has been pretty even between these guys. Right now though, D2000 in control, sitting Nucci out right out here in front of me. Now D2000 immediately sending Nucci back into the ring. I think he just wanted to hit that thin padding, nothing but concrete underneath, folks. Now another hammerlock back suplex there by D2000. Nice counter there, arm drag counter there by Nucci. And a big suplex, deadlift suplex by Nucci. Nucci can fly, but he's got some power offense too, folks. Oh, but now Nucci sent shoulder first into that turnbuckle post. Nucci doing everything he can to fight back here, trying to avoid the offense and counter out. There's another Dragon Sleeper. He's trying to go technical for technical with D2000. I don't know if you want to do that. Now D2000 picking the leg and then dropping his own leg across his leg. Now once again, get that arm, working the legs and the arm, and twisting and snapping the arm on that mat. And once again, that rolling face lock on the mat. Wear down tactics are coming here by D2000. Michi trying to get a breath here quickly, taking advantage of D2, who is deciding to taunt him here, delivering a pair of strikes, and now sending D2000 into the corner here. D2000 counters with an arm drag. Big strike, knee strike straight to the face. D2000 heading up to the top rope. And he's flying, he dives right on him. Nucci was getting to his feet and drops that elbow right on top of his dome. Now sending Nucci back in the ring. But he might have been going for the cover. Instead of going to send him in the corner, he's going to go for the brain buster. Might be good getting them set up for that corner brain buster. And he's got him up there. Nice counter there by Nucci. Coming off the rope looking for a big lariat. But a nice Northern Lights suplex counter by D2000. And now he's got him in this cross face. That LaBelle lock. Oh, but Nucci able to break the hands and break the lock. Break the hold, and now monkey flip. Nucci is starting to feel it here in this matchup. Oh, going for a big lariat there, D2000 counters. But he's coming, he's still coming right at him. Running on momentum. Is Nucci. And oh, what nice counter by D2000. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, brain buster. He got him.
And your winner, D2000.
Well, D2000 getting it done in this amazing matchup. With the Brainbuster moving on in this tournament. Gonna update this bracket and you're gonna see D2000 in the finals of Bracket B against Xander, folks. Coming up next, Bracket D is gonna be completed as Anders goes at one-on-one with Angelo Morocco. The winner, of course, going on to face BLK.
The following match is a Bracket D match scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from London, England, weighing in at 265 pounds, he is Anders.
Well, another member of Atami, Anders, is here tonight going against their biggest rival in the last month or so, Angelo Morocco. And you saw what Anders did to Morocco on Saturday night's Main Event 7. We gotta think that might come into play here tonight. The 2021 Summer Classic Tournament.
His opponent from New York City, New York, weighing in at 320 pounds, he is Angelo Morocco.
Angelo Morocco, he's gotta have ice running through his veins tonight because he can't think about his rivalry with Atami. Oh! He can't be thinking about that. He's got to be focused on getting to the World Championship in the main event of CyberSlam 7. Gentlemen, the Fireman and Anders, Angelo Morocco is ready, and so is Anders. Been saying it all night long. Everybody on this roster, they're ready for two nights of action, and only a few people are going to be able to make it through two nights. Half the roster here tonight isn't going to make it. And these two men have been going at each other, seems like all year long, if not up close, but from a distance. It seems like this has been a matchup that we have been waiting to see for a very long time. And it's good to see some wrestling, a lockup here in this matchup to kick it off. Angelo Morocco, and off to side headlock. Nice shoulder takedown there, shoulder block takedown there by Anders. Now throwing the kicks here, and Anders, oh! Immediately coming out the gate, using his style with those strikes. There's little Morocco trying to shake him off here. He can throw some strikes of his own. Oh! Disrespectful slap right to the face. And Anders, oh! Strikes, those are lethal. Anders, you gotta think that he would love to be able to go to the CyberSlam 7 main event. All of these guys here who lost tonight, you gotta think they're disappointed. And I think it'd be very disappointing for Angelo Morocco if he can't get by Atami and Anders here tonight. Right now, Morocco with a big gorilla press drop. He's getting fired up, folks. But Anders, you gotta keep an eye on him. What's he going for here? Oh! Big back suplex drop there. And Anders trying to get in the head of Angelo Morocco. And oh! Big back drop suplex there. Now, oh, what is he doing here? What is this? Talk about, oh God. When you talk about mind games, those are some literal mind games there. That, It can cause your mind to go unconscious. Now, got that camel clutch locked in, raking at the face. Doesn't have to be pretty, as long as you get it done. Angelo Morocco, though, countering out. Now, big suplex there. Deadlift style by Angelo Morocco. 2021 Summer Classic tournament bracket is shaping up, and these two guys looking to advance. Nice reverse DDT there. Nice sequence going on between Anders and Angelo Morocco. That was a night. Nothing nice about that. Just some stiff kicks to the face there. And Angelo Morocco, all that did was wake him up. Nice shoulder block takedown there. Now, going for a big power bomb here, perhaps. Oh! That falling power bomb by the fireman. You gotta think he's used to taking some falls like that and having to catch himself and all those fires. And now, speaking of falling, coming down off the top rope, the double axe handle, only getting a one count. Angelo Morocco staying focused, as I said that he needed to do in this matchup. So far, so good for Angelo Morocco. Irish whip here, duck under. Now, oh, psyching him out there, and then coming right at him with that left arm lariat. Now, Angelo Morocco wisely bringing his opponent to the center of the ring, going for a cover, only getting a one count. Anders, nice counter there by Anders. I was really going to say, Anders got some catching up to do. Nice uppercut palm strike there. And now, centering on the middle of the ring and snapping the arm down on the mat. And Anders looking to do it for a Tommy here tonight. But this is not a team effort. He's got to do it for himself. Stalemate lock up there, and now, nice suplex. Standing suplex there by Anders. Angelo Morocco might have been going for that backdrop suplex again. Angelo Morocco had it scouted and countered it. Countered that half and half there. These guys, oh! Have each other scouted. We've been seeing a lot of each other lately. Their dealings with Itami. Oh, look at these kicks and the knee straight to the jaw. And now, oh, big overhead choke toss by Anders. Now he is in firm control of this matchup. I thought this was just going to be another walk in the park for him, because he was going right along, but ascension slam by Anders as he is come back into this matchup, hitting his finishing maneuver, and he's got him.
And your winner, Anders.
Well, there you see it, Angelo Morocco falling to the Ascension Slam. Apropos as it is, what an amazing comeback that was in this matchup by Anders. It looked like Angelo Morocco there toward the last couple of minutes of the matchup, right before that, seemed like he had it won, but Anders with an incredible comeback, getting it done, and we're gonna see his name go up on that bracket as he advances, and he will face VLK. Wow, what an amazing matchup that's gonna be. And ladies and gentlemen, coming up next to our main event of the evening, a rematch from Cyber Slam 6, Dane Xavier and Vega. And folks, this match marks the end of the first round of the 2021 Summer Classic Tournament.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it is a bracket, a match. Introducing first, from Tokyo, Japan, by the way of Bad Street, being accompanied by Jasmine, and weighing in at 307 pounds, he is Dane Xavier.
We gotta think Dane Xavier. Gotta be feeling himself more than ever after, in his mind, defeating D2000, quote-unquote, clean in the middle of the ring for the first time in his career. But I disagree with that, and I think you at home will too, because he attacked D2000 with a chair before that matchup. Damn wonder D2000 was able to win here tonight. But I digress, ladies and gentlemen. It's going to be a big matchup, and I'm excited for it.
And his opponent, from Atlanta City, weighing in at 223 pounds, he is Will Vega.
What are you talking about, a rematch of Cyber Slam 6? Vega loves hot moms, and he has got the hottest of all the moms with him here tonight, just like it's Cyber Slam 6. Talk about mind games. This is Vega's style of mind games here, ladies and gentlemen. If you don't know Vega, well, you're in for a treat, ladies and gentlemen. I feel like it's Cyber Slam 6 all over again. Gentlemen, big match up here. What is going on here? Jasmine getting into an argument with Vega here. Oh, but wait a minute. Oh, wait a minute. Granny Xavier. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Granny Xavier. She's slapping the hell out of Jasmine DeJore. And now Jasmine running for the hills. And I can't blame her after those slaps from an Xavier and Vega and Dave just watching on. How can you blame them? I mean, I know they got this big tournament matchup here in this main event, but how could you help but stand by and watch that? But Oh, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Big main event. The Summer Classics. I got to get it together here. The 2021 Summer Classic Tournament is concluding here in this matchup. And the big slaps, just like CyberSlam 6. Oh, well, wait a minute. Dan Xavier, he's all business here tonight with those kicks. You don't see him. You only see him lift that leg up for one move usually, and that's the Bad Street Boot. But tonight, he's all business in this matchup. Now, nice hammerlock there, but Vega countering, delivering the knee. Dane does not go down. Delivering the body block. Vega does not go down. Into the corner now. Oh, nice counter by Vega. Oh, and a nice arm drag. Oh, and that lariat there. Off to a quick start here in this matchup. Wow. Now Vega turning Dan Xavier over here. Oh, got him waist lock, deadlifts, German suplex there. But Dane was in the ropes. Now, gonna powder out, get a breath here. After seeing some quick offense, Dan Xavier looking to slow it down. Back in the ring, sending Vega into the corner. Oh, and Vega countering with that big elbow. Back and forth we go here. Oh, and Dane now delivering the big slap. Oh, and now referee Tim Horton, you got to get in there. He's choking him on that top rope. This is a pure matchup. I know it's the main event, but it's still a 10-minute time limit. Oh, a big slap. Slaps back and forth. Now some chops. Oh, man. Oh. Dane Xavier lays in those chops. With the best of them, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, another one. Sends Vega to the mat. Here's the cover. Only a one count. Never forget CyberSlam 6. Vega getting a big victory there. Delivering that coast to coast. Sending Dane's head into the ladder. And before that, breaking Dane's pretend title. What a wonderful night that was, CyberSlam 6. Oh! Now Vega, nice combination there. And then delivering a famouser, getting a two count out of him. Also saw Piper lose the World Heavyweight Championship at CyberSlam 6. He's hoping that he can reclaim that for the first time here tomorrow night on night two of the Summer Classic Tournament. Oh, but wait a minute. Vega locking Dane's arm up here. Now, oh, springing into the ring. That senton. Now the Vega heat. That's how you know the Vega heat's ready to pick up. Oh, wait a minute. Dane. He didn't need to call a fireman. He put it out of himself. And now the Tiger Bomb by Dan Xavier. What's he going for here? Vega back to his feet. Oh, wait a minute. Tiger Suplex by Dan Xavier. That's something new we don't usually see him do. Here's the cover. Hook of the leg. Oh, and only a one count. A long one count by Tim Horton. Oh, and Dan Xavier slowed this match down to his pace. That's when he can take control. Oh, big chop. Vega countering with one of his own. Oh, and that big slap sends Dane to a knee. And now, oh, that inverted crusher there by Vega. Oh, and getting a two count out of it. Dan Xavier, I think he just likes to preserve himself and kick out the latest moment possible. And that's his MO. That's his MO in these matchups, in these tournament matchups. That's what you gotta do. You gotta try to slow it down sometimes. And now, nice deadlift, reverse suplex there by Vega. The Vega Heat starting to pick back up, starting to rekindle, going to the top rope. Oh, and Dane just puts it right back out. Vega getting out of the way of that. Oh, and delivering a knee straight to the ribs of Dan Xavier. And taking a moment to lay up on the top rope. Vega is classy as ever, ladies and gentlemen. Now big slap to the face. Vega talking a little smack to Dan Xavier. One of his biggest rivalries here in Ring of Chaos, and now sending Dan Xavier onto the apron and delivering a series of strikes here. Dan Xavier claps into the mat. Vega gonna go for cover off of that, but Dan Xavier wisely once again in preservation mode, grabbing that bottom rope, preventing from having to kick out and use expend energy. That's what Dan Xavier is all about. Now, counter by Dan Xavier. Oh, now body splash in the corner. Now Dan Xavier, what's he looking for here? Oh my God! Big power bomb shoulder breaker there by Dan Xavier. Preservation brings the bigger moves, getting a two count out of it. Oh, what a stiff kick to the back now. And now the Dane Heat is starting to pick up, I guess. Oh, wait a minute. Dan Xavier going for un angel ulado. That's Vega's finishing maneuver. Oh, and he kicks out at one. Dan Xavier in disbelief in the corner. Vega, that's got to snap him out of it. He's got to snap out of it now. Oh, Dan Xavier using his moves against him. Oh, I thought he was going to have it there. Dan Xavier getting a two count out of that face buster. We saw Vega use that move for the first time in his career. He's adding more moves to his arsenal as well. He used it on Saturday Night's Main Event. Oh, wait a minute. Roll up here, playing possum. Dan Xavier was posing on the top rope. Oh, and Dan Xavier just kicking out at two. Now, the Vega Heat now gonna pick up this time. And there it is, the Famouser. He could have him off of that. Here's the cover, hook to the leg. Oh, only a one count. Dan Xavier kicking out. Now Vega going to the top rope. This is what Dane went for at Cyber Slam 6. Oh! But Dane getting the knees up. Vega hit it. It could have been over. But now Dane. What's it going for here? Oh, looking for the jackpot. He's got him up for it. Oh, and there it is. Here's the cover. Lateral press. And Dan Xavier advances.
And the winner, Dan Xavier.
Well, here you see Dan Xavier getting it done with that jackpot. Beating Vega clean in the middle of the ring. Unlike what he did the D2000, that is not what he did to him on Saturday night's main event, ladies and gentlemen. And Dan Xavier celebrating this victory. Wait a minute. Pulling money out of his trunks there. What's he going to do with that? Gonna give him a tip, I guess. Oh, that's not where that goes. Come on. Well, I guess this is a never-ending rivalry between Vega and the man who advances. There you see it, Dan Xavier, who will face Reed Nevermore Andrews tomorrow night in Bracket A. And then in Bracket B, we'll have D2000 and Xander. Bracket C, Sean Extreme and Kane. Bracket D, VLK and Anders. We'll also have a pure title match, a world title match, and of course the semifinals and the finals. Thank you so much for joining us here, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight. Oh, wait a minute. What the hell is this? Oh, it's Dice, ladies and gentlemen. Vegas' good friend Dice is here to help his buddy up. Like, oh, wait a minute. Oh, God. He just hit him with the Ace Crusher. Well, I saw him shooting those birds at him. I thought I was just having a little bit of fun with him. And then posing for the camera right in front of him. What the hell is that all about? Well, ladies and gentlemen, we'll see you tomorrow night. Ah, Dice, come on.
Ring of Chaos, what the world is watching.